So let's talk real quick about firewalls. And this question comes up a lot. People always ask me, is this firewall good? Is that firewall good? The reality is, they all are going to need patches. There's always going to be something that they find that causes a problem that causes you to be patched. So you have to make sure it's up to date. That's one of the first rules about any firewall you get. But you have the ones you can find at maybe a retail store like the Netgears and Linksys, and then you have your more commercial ones like, let's say, Cisco, Juniper, or Fortinet. And the question is a big, almost religious style debate of who has the best firewall. And I always kind of lean towards believing that open source firewalls make for better firewalls because hiding things doesn't work. And that's one of the problems a lot of these companies do. They don't have a good grasp on code auditing, I would guess. Someone thought it was a good idea to hard code a password, and that happens way more often than it should in 2017. And we'll run down some of the issues here. So here's the Netgear, and there was a nasty unpatched vulnerability exposes Netgear routers to easy hacking. And so there's a vulnerability for it, and it turns out it doesn't require any authentication, and people turn these into, of course, botnets, which means from the time the problem occurred, all these people that have these installed, and lots of small businesses are very at risk for this, their routers got turned into botnets because generally they had their friend install it, they're not managed by any type of security company, and they're not being audited to make sure that they have a firewall that is properly patched. Therefore, they become part of the giant botnet. And lots of home users are vulnerable to this as well. Because these companies, I'm not sure what they were thinking or not thinking. Security is hard. I'm not a security expert in terms of writing code, but some things seem obvious and some best practices should be followed. And now recently we have Aris, and this is September of 2017, and we just found out that Aris has been hard coding some passwords in there. So apparently, with a lot of the Aris cable modems provided by lots of the cable providers, the default user remote SSH and 5SA P9I26 was a valid username password combination hard coded into these. And hopefully they have a firmware update by now that gets these fixed. But they found three back doors in these things. Anytime these companies, anytime someone stops and go, let's hard code a password into our device, you're asking for trouble. You're asking for a device that, you know, security through obscurity. Horrible idea. It's 2017. We got to stop that practice. So I don't know what came through their heads about this, but here's the other side of it. Here's Fortinet, a definitely commercial one. You're not going to find this on a shelf at Best Buy. Fortinet makes a commercial firewall. That's a very popular one. It's a strong firewall, but they hard coded a password as well. I do like the fact that it's a higher entropy password, so it is a lot longer than your usual at FGTABC11 star XY plus QQZ27. Okay, we got a better password, and the username is FortiManager underscore access. But why is it hard coded in here? This is just a horrible idea. Good news is Fortinet, after it was disclosed with them, someone was able to get a patch out after it was properly disclosed. And apparently, builds between 2012 and 2014 contained this. Now, unfortunately, there's probably some IT administrator that is overburdened with his office and has not updated his Fortinet from 2014, and this vulnerability still persists. Now, hopefully, they don't have SSH open to the public, but some of them do because they say, I just want to be able to work on it from home. So you have a compounding problem of security. First, Fortinet decided to put a backdoor in there for convenience. And then for convenience again, you probably have some IT administrator going, I just want to work on it from home and I don't want to VPN in and then get into it. So a couple lapses in security, and we have a major problem. But they're not alone. Here's Juniper firewalls, and they found that they had a backdoor open since 2012. And let's see, this was published in 2015, so it's been a little while, but they released a series of patches as well. But back to why did they hard code this? And this is what it comes down to with the firewalls. You really need good support, and then you need someone applying those patches for the support. So these are things you need to think of about security. Now, firewalls aren't the only way security breaches happen. Matter of fact, the majority of security breaches are not from the firewall, but they're from the users clicking on something on the other side of the firewall. But it's still really important because when a vulnerability is found, it is very quickly turned into an automated task that bots run around and install things. So this has to come into your thought that if this attack occurs, it escalates very quickly, as it did here with the Netgear, and turns them into botnets that go around attacking more Netgears with these default usernames and passwords. This is one of the reasons I'm such an advocate for open source security. I do not believe in security through obscurity. I believe in best practice. I'm partial to pfSense because I've used it a lot. We deployed it a lot for clients. It works really well. But they're not the only open source company out there making good firewalls. I think more of these firewall companies should be open source, though, because having people look at your code, security practices such as hard coding a password for convenience are not accepted in the open source world. Any major open source product, especially one like pfSense that has gone through code audits, they will not allow something like that. They just know it would be embarrassing to have a submit in your change data going, we decided to hard code a password to make life easier for you. That won't fly. I don't know why it flies in some of these other companies or who thinks that's a good idea, but when you start developing things in a bubble, in your own bubble of thinking, I'm just going to use a really complicated password. That way, anytime we have to do testing, you know, it's conveniently there. That won't fly in the open source world. That's one of the reasons I'm such an advocate for open source firewalls, pfSense, and many others. So I just want to share those thoughts on security. The good news is most of these vulnerabilities, have been mitigated, but stop and think and stop and patch. If you're using one of these consumer firewalls especially, or if you're using the firewall provided by your cable provider, what makes it even scarier with them is sometimes they apply their own updates and changes to the firewall. We ran into that with some of the old Comcast ones forcing the management port open on their firewalls. And they don't do that now, but some of the older models, that was a discovered, not a vulnerability, but it was an annoyance because you can't pass PCI compliance with it forced open. And Comcast said it was for management purposes. But most of these firewalls or firewall combination cable modems that you get from places like your cable provider can be put in bridge mode, is what we do for our clients, is bridge them over to a better firewall. So this is less of an issue, and we're not relying on the hopefulness that they update the firmware on their system if a vulnerability is found. So the goal is to keep everyone protected. But my opinion back to open source, that's kind of the way to go with this. But no matter which one you go with, please keep it patched, keep it updated, and keep an eye on that. Those updates are very important. So that's my little morning thoughts on firewalls here as I'm running through and looking for seeing these vulnerabilities in these Aris modems and deciding what needs to be done about them. If it's something, because we have a few clients with them, I just wanted to share my thoughts on firewalls in general and my always dumbfoundedness every time I find out another hard-coded password was put in because these companies apparently think that's a good idea. Because here in September 2017, we should not be hard coding passwords because someone will find them. The internet's big and leaks go fast. So if you'd like to comment here, like and subscribe. Just want to share that with you guys. And thanks a lot.